Yesterday, I gave you a few questions for homework. ये यहाँ पर है. इसमें से कोई specific question में problem गई है, तो you can ask me in the chat. वैसे तो आई ट्राई एंड डू एज मेनी एज आई कैन जो मुझे लगते हैं कि थोड़े डिफिकल्ट होंगे, या आई शो यू द सॉल्यूशंस दैट वुड बी इजियर आई थिंक. चिप सैलेड अनियंस वाला कुछ आई थिंक दिस 2.11 इज दिस चिप सैलेड अनियन वाला क्वेश्चन. सो दे आर सेइंग अ कस्टमर एट अ रेस्टोरेंट मे ऑर्डर एनी कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ चिप सैलेड और अनियन रिंग्स. द प्रोबेबिलिटी दैट द कस्टमर chooses onion ring is 0.3, salad is 0.4, and chips and salad is 0.15. chips and onion rings is this much, all three are this, none is this. Whenever we have and, we are talking about combination, that would be our intersection. All three means tino ka intersection. Now see, uske hisab se given information, onion, salad, then we have chips and salad, so intersection chips and onion salad or onion bola hua yahan par, solid or salad or onion becomes our union, and all three together we'll have triple intersection. So they are asking us, and none is 0.2, so नन भी दिया हुआ है. सो उसके हिसाब से हम लोगों को कैलकुलेट करना है. कैलकुलेट द प्रोबेबिलिटी अ कस्टमर चूजेस चिप्स ओनली, चिप्स एंड चिप्स ओनली. ओके, सो चिप्स ओनली वी नो व्हाट दैट लुक्स लाइक. ये हम लोगों ने कल किया था. तो ट्रिपल इंटरसेक्शन के जब दिया रहता है, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यूनियन निकालने के लिए विल से यूनिवर्सल सेट में से नन अगर सब्ट्रैक्ट करेंगे तो वी आर गोइंग टू गेट आर यूनियन. सो इसीलिए यहाँ पर आर यूनियन बिकम्स 1 - 0.2. देन उसके बाद वील रिक्वायर दिस, सो उसके लिए इसके यूनियन से निकाला, एंड देन पीसी भी निकाल लिया, एंड आफ्टर दैट वी हैव यूनियन वाली. सो फर्स्ट वाले पार्ट में कैलकुलेट द प्रोबेबिलिटी the customer chooses chips, so that becomes this, that is using our triple union wala jo formula tha wo hi directly use kiya hua hai. And then uske baad when we say chips only, we are talking about c intersection s not intersection o not, theek hai, ya ye chips only wala. So usually ye jo only wale questions rehte hain wo agar tum venn diagram se karoge to it becomes very 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 easy. जैसे अब यहाँ पर जो सारी वैल्यूज थी, सो उसके हिसाब से इफ वी ड्रॉ अ वेन डायग्राम, ड्रॉ वेन डायग्राम, जो जो वैल्यूज दी हुई है वील ऑलवेज गो फ्रॉम द इनर मोस्ट के लिए वील हैव ट्रिपल इंटरसेक्शन इज 0.05. आई विल ड्रॉ अ बिगर वेन डायग्राम जस्ट सो दैट यू ऑल कैन सी प्रॉपरली. So let's say this chips, salad, and onion. Triple intersection is 0.05. Then we are saying chips intersection onion. Chips intersection onion is ye wala region. That is 0.15, but usme se 0.05 is already in our triple intersection. So baki jo bachega, that is going to be 0.1. That becomes this region. Similarly, chips intersection salad is also 0.15. That becomes again 0.1. Then I think ye question mein ye intersection, ha, ye intersection bhi 0.15 aya. So again this becomes 0.1. Then onion is 0.3. Onion is 0.3. So fir ye wala jo total onion ka o wala jo pura circle hai, that should make 0.3. So 0.3 must be total. So fir we have onion only. Okay, o only. Plus we'll have 0.1 plus 0.1 plus 0.05. Clearly onion only is going to be 0.05. Similarly you can do it here. S ke liye bhi 0.4 hai total, so 2.5 already hai yahan par, so this becomes 0.15. and यहां पर C के लिए टोटल C केम आउट टू बी 0.5 ऑलरेडी है 0.25, सो 0.25 बचेगा यहां पर एंड बाहर वॉज 0.2. इस तरीके से हम लोग वेन डायग्राम बनाएंगे एंड जस्ट बाय लुकिंग एट द वेन डायग्राम यू कैन टेल दैट C ओनली इज 0.02. So this is much easier than actually making this equation. But agar ye equation banana bhi hai, especially if other you know such values are given, then we have done that as well. Then next question. ठीक है, I don't think ये दोनों question के solution यहाँ पर है क्या? Yeah, ये life office A life office B वाला जो है, that is this solution. I think this was pretty simple. In a group of 24 actuaries, 20 work for life office A, 12 work for life office B. Everyone in the group work for at least one of these two companies. What is the probability that an actuary picked at random has worked for life office A and B? That would be intersection. And life office A given, they have worked for life office B. That would be A given B. Okay. So you can see the solution here. Intersection wala is 8/24 and A given B is 2/3. Fraction mein agar answer likh rahe ho to always in the lowest fraction possible, so I think this would be 1/3. So us hisab se answer hamesha karna hai. Okay, isme koi problem tha? चलो आगे ये अ कार्ड इज पिक फ्रॉम एन ऑर्डिनरी पैक ऑफ 52 कार्ड्स विदाउट रिप्लेसमेंट एंड देन अनदर वन इज पिक्ड व्हाट इज द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ पिकिंग टू रेड कार्ड्स वन ऑफ ईच कलर. Now yesterday we talked about this with replacement, without replacement, but I don't think कि मैंने without replacement को कैसे solve करना चाहिए वो बताया. Okay, so we'll do that right now कि without replacement वाले questions कैसे solve करते हैं. Now the easiest way of solving without replacement questions is going to be using combinations. So combinations use करेंगे तो फिर बहुत easily आ जाता. Remember, this is all without replacement. So, जैसे यहाँ पे बोला हुआ है, a card is picked from an ordinary pack of 52 playing cards without replacement, and another one is picked. That means दो card pick किए without replacement, and we need to find what is the probability that two cards, two red cards आएंगे. ठीक है. So we'll say probability of getting two red will be equal to combinations में हम लोग क्या करेंगे, we'll say out of 52 I have to pick two red cards. So there are how many red cards? So we have half of them as red. So कितने 36 हाँ. So 36 red cards में से I have to select any two. Upon this is my desired outcome. Upon total outcomes out of 52, I need to select any two. So this becomes how we will solve whenever we have without replacement. ये क्या हो जाता है? This will be 36C2. Now first of all combination का मैं तुमको एक simple सा trick बता देता हूँ. For combination first of all our NCR is equals to NC n minus R. So if you have a very large number here, more than half in your R, you should convert it into n minus R ताकि छोटा number आ जाए. Okay. And secondly, like this, we have 36C2 will be 36 into 35 by 2. Now how do we get that? If I have something like 13C5, it is from 13 go 5 numbers, from n go n r numbers. So we'll have 13 into 12 into 11 into 10 into 9. These are 5 numbers divided by 5 factorial. So it will be 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 into 5. Okay, so isi tarike se this is what we actually got here. Okay. So, इस तरीके से फाइंड कर सकते हो. या फिर दूसरा क्या है, हमारे कैलकुलेटर में वी ऑलरेडी हैव एनपीआर एंड एनसीआर. यू कैन सी मल्टीप्लीकेशन एंड डिवीजन के ऊपर यू हैव एनपीआर एंड एनसीआर. यू कैन डायरेक्टली यूज दैट. सो यहाँ पर कैसे यूज करेंगे, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल दे आर गिवन इन येल्लो, दैट मीन्स वी हैव टू यूज आर ये क्या बोलते 26. अच्छा मैंने 36 लिख दिया, ठीक है, माई मिस्टेक. 26 ठीक है. सो कॉम्बिनेशन के लिए व्हाट वी हैव टू डू इज वी हैव टू फर्स्ट राइट आर 26, देन वी वांट सी, तो शिफ्ट दबाकर we'll press this division. You can see C आ गया and then 26C2. 26C2 divided by we want 52C2. We are getting 0.245. So our answer is 0.245. If you want to write it in decimals, or sorry, in fractions, you can convert it. You are getting 25 by 102. if you use combination, it becomes very easy for us to solve these type of questions. Then uska jo second part hai, one of each color. So probability of one red, one black. This is what we need to find. So we'll say out of 26 red, I have to select any one of them. So 26 C1. And out of 26 black, I have to select any one. So I have 26 C1. Upon out of 52, I need to select any two. Okay. So again, we can do this. We'll have 26 C1 is 26. So I will not do 26 C1. Okay, just do 26. And then divided by, we'll have 52 C2. 52 C2. So we have 26 by 51. That we can convert it into this as well, fraction. This is 26 by 51. That is 0.5098. Similarly, if I wanted to select, let's say 10 cards without replacement. Isme, agar mujhe 10 cards hote and I needed to see what is the probability that I will get 4 red and 6 black. Ye find karna hota. So fir I would say I will have 26 C4, 26 C6 upon we'll have 52 C 10. वो भी हम फट से फाइंड कर सकते हैं. We'll have 26 C4 into 26 C6 by 52 C 10. And this is our answer. We can convert it into decimal and we'll get our answer. So any such question jahan pe we have without replacement. Sabse pehle to, if we have living things, it will always be without replacement. If we have non-living things, it can be with replacement or without replacement. So jab cards ki baat kar rahe hain, balls ki baat kar rahe hain, aise cheezon ki baat kar rahe hain, it can be with replacement or without replacement. If I say in a bag, I have five blue, then seven red, and let's say nine green balls. Okay. And I need to find what is the probability that if I select three balls, I will get all three blue. So if I want three blue, total kitne? 14, 21 hai. So I will get 5 mein se I need to select any 3. That would be my desired outcome. And 21 mein se I will be selecting any 3. Similarly, if I want 2 blue and 1 red. So I will have 5 mein se 2, 7 mein se 1 upon 21 may say 3. Similarly, if I want all 3, ek ek aane chahiye. So probability that I will have 1 blue, 1 red, 1 green. I have 5 C1, 7 C1, 9 C1 upon 21 C1. So 21 C3. So this is how we will calculate it. So whenever we have with replacement, अब वो उसकी बात कर लेते हैं. So अगर मैं replacement के साथ बोलूँगा, तो क्या फर्क पड़ जाएगा? So if I say that I take a ball then see what color it is and then replace it back into the bag and then I select another. So kya hoga? Every single time when I select a ball, the ratio of the ball inside the bag is always same. So first time I had 5 balls out of 21. Okay, so this was without replacement. I'll just do with replacement here. The probability of getting 3 blue balls. Just 1 minute. Okay, I'll just mute it. Okay, I'm just, you know, video or audio mein 2 minute ke liye band kar raha hu. I'll be back, okay? So I'm back. So if we are talking about with replacement, so first ball ke liye I had a probability of getting my first ball was 5 blue mein se out of 21 balls. Now because I replaced it back, the probability of blue balls is same in the second one as well. I will still have 5 upon 21 and third ke liye bhi 5 upon 21. Same tarike se probability of getting 2 blue and 1 red. Now, whenever we have such options, jahan pe do different options hai, the thing is, I will have 3 different combinations. I can get pehle wale isme red mil sakta hai and then blue mil sakta hai, ya blue mil sakta hai. Then red and then blue, or I can get blue and then red. Now if I had more such balls, just say agar main bolta hoon ki I had let's say 3 blue and 1 red, so I would have much more combinations. Okay, so is tarike se hum logo ko sare combinations ko saath mein lena padega. The probability of getting red blue is going to be equal to red ki probability was 7. 7 out of 21. And because we replaced it back, we still have only 21 balls. So we'll have 5 by 21 and 5 by 21. Yahan pe we'll have 5 by 21, then 7 by 21, and then 5 by 21. Here we'll have 5 by 21, 5 by 21, and then 7 by 21. And all 3 are same. These are all alternatives of each other. Either I will get RBB or BRB or BBR. So because they are alternatives of each other, probabilities will be added. Ye cheez hamesha dhyan rakhna, whenever things are happening together, then we multiply the probability. when things are alternatives of each other, we add the probability. So it just becomes three times this. Now every time we'll not be able to calculate how many different combinations we are going to get. So what we do is we use the combination formula. So we are going to say ki yahan par, first of all, we'll have to see how many combinations of this we are going to get. So you can say that ye teen ball jo select kiye hue hai usme se do same hai aur ek alag hai. So we'll say out of three balls we need to select any one to one position to fill the red one, or you can say you have to select any two position to fill the blue ones. Similarly, you will have either 3C1 or 3C2. It's the same thing because 3C1 NCR is equals to NCN minus R. So that is why it is same. And then just multiply the probability. So we'll have 5/21 into 5/21 into 7/21. This way you are going to get your answer. Similarly, last wala jo tha, we'll have one blue, one red, one green. Ab isme kaise combinations banenge? We'll say out of three positions, I have to select out of three, I have to select any one into out of three, out of the remaining two, I will have to select any one. So ab kya ho gaya? Pehle तीन पोजीशंस में से एक सिलेक्ट किया, उसमें ब्लू को डाला, फिर बाकी दो में से एक सिलेक्ट किया, उसमें रेड को डाला, एंड देन जो बची हुई पोजीशन थी उसमें ग्रीन को डाल दिया. सो दीज आर द कॉम्बिनेशंस दैट आई एम गोइंग टू गेट. और यू कैन से इट इज नथिंग बट 3 factorial, 3 into 2. ओके, बट ऐसे भी लिख सकते हो. एंड फिर उसके बाद प्रोबेबिलिटी वुड बी 5/21 इंटू 7/21 into 9/21. So this is how you will solve with replacement and without replacement wale questions. Okay, so with replacement directly combinations, without replacement directly combinations se hum log solve karenge. With replacement the probabilities remain same जितने भी वैल्यू सिलेक्ट कर रहे हैं, बट यू विल हैव टू फाइंड कॉम्बिनेशंस ऑफ द ऑर्डर्स. इसके ऊपर आई विल गिव यू मोर क्वेश्चंस लेटर ऑन एंड देन वी विल डिस्कस देम. इसके अलावा और कोई क्वेश्चन है जिसमें प्रॉब्लम गई होगी? ये हो गया. देन क्वेश्चन नंबर 4, अ बॉक्स ऑफ चॉकलेट कंटेन्स 8 मिल्क चॉकलेट्स एंड 4 प्लेन चॉकलेट्स. अ चोकोहोलिक ईट्स 3 चॉकलेट्स. कैलकुलेट द प्रोबेबिलिटी दैट ऑल 3 आर मिल्क, वन एग्जैक्टली 1 इज प्लेन चॉकलेट. सो यू कैन सॉल्व इट एग्जैक्टली द सेम वे. व्हेन अ पर्सन ईट्स अ चॉकलेट डेफिनेटली कैनॉट रिप्लेस इट बैक. सो clearly it is without replacement. All three are milk. So out of, you will say out of 8 milk chocolates you need to select 3, and out of total 12 chocolates you have to select 3. So 8c3/12c3 you will get the same answer kyunki yahan par aaya hua hai. Ye bhi method, ye tree diagram method main maybe baad mein samjhaunga. It's easy but you know I will use other examples to you know explain what they have done here. You'll get 14/55. We can check that. We'll have 8c3/12c3. See, 14/55, we have the same answer. Okay, and this is so much easier using combinations rather than any other method. Then सेकेंड वाला वन ऑफ नहीं एग्जैक्टली वन प्लेन वन इज प्लेन चॉकलेट सो आउट ऑफ थ्री वी हैव वन प्लेन सो अदर टू मस्ट बी मिल्क चॉकलेट्स सो वी हैव टू मिल्क एंड वन प्लेन वी वॉन्ट प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ टू मिल्क एंड वन प्लेन जैसे अभी हम लोगों ने बोला था टू मिल्क एंड वन प्लेन ऑल यू हैव टू डू इज 8C2 आउट ऑफ 8 मिल्क चॉकलेट्स वी हैव टू सिलेक्ट 2 एंड 4C1 आउट ऑफ 4 प्लेन चॉकलेट्स वी हैव टू सिलेक्ट 1 एंड डिनोमिनेटर में 12C3 आई विल डू इट हियर इसी में एडिट कर देता हूं so we have 28/55 and we can see here solution may be we have 28/55 so combination becomes very easy when we are talking about without replacement फिर लास्ट वाला भी सॉल्यूशन दिखा देता हूँ दैट वाज आल्सो सिंपल अ कस्टमर ऑर्डर्स फ्रॉम द सेट मेन्यू एंड अ कस्टमर ऑर्डर्स फ्रॉम द लेकार्ट मेन्यू इज फीमेल सो यू कैन सी दैट चलो आगे बढ़ते हैं अभी दीज वर द क्वेश्चंस सो यस्टरडे वी वर प्रोबेबिलिटी लॉ ऑफ टोटल प्रोबेबिलिटी की बात कर रहे थे Law of total probability. Isme we had two assumptions. The first one, we assume that we have n mutually exclusive and exhaustive events. E1 se lekar EN tak ke. Theek hai? Yahan pe diagram bhi banaya tha. So, we have E1 se EN tak ke n exclusive, mutually exclusive and exhaustive events. That means there is nothing in common between each of them. That is why probability intersection key is always zero and they are completing everything so exhausting so isliye union karke we are getting one then we said second assumption let there be an event A with some elements common with some of E1 to EN so we have cut out some values of this particular event A then we are trying to find what is the probability of A so we said probability of A must be probability of A intersection E1 this part A intersection E2 the second part say lekar A intersection EN last part we are just adding each parts and because of our conditional probability This is our formula for conditional probability. We said that probability of A intersection E1 must be equal to probability of E1 into A given E1. So we use that and then we made a general formula. Now, what does this actually mean? Now, let's assume that I have, let's say 50, I'll take 30, let's say 30 balls here. Jisme se I have 15 black and 15 white balls. Now, isme if I ask you what is the probability of selecting a white ball, So very simple, we'll say 15 white balls divided by 30. So clearly our probability is half. Probability of selecting a white ball is half. But what if I tell you that there are some more complications? If I say these balls are not readily available for you to select, if I say they are kept in three different bags, I have three different bags. In the first bag, I have seven black balls and three white balls. In the second one, I have five black, five white. In the last one, I have three black. अच्छा नहीं मैंने total 10 कर दिया. एक काम करते हैं, I will take 20 balls and I will say 10 black. नहीं सही था, minus. So 7 black, 3 white, 5 black, 5 white, 3 black, 7. Chalo. So we had 3 bags and just a minute, okay. Sab log abhi tak add new hai. Just wait 2 minutes for others to come back. So let's start again. So we were talking about, we have some more complication. Those balls are kept in three different bags. So we have bag 1, 2, and 3. And I say that bag 1 is near me. So the probability of selecting this bag 1 is, let's say, half. Instead of B, I will write it as E. I'll just say this is E1. And because these bag 2 and bag 3 are a little bit far away from me, probability of selecting this E2 is equals to 1 by 4. And probability of selecting this E3 is equals to 1 by 4. Now, because the probability of selecting this bag 1 is more than the others, more likely I will be selecting this bag. And if I select this bag, you can clearly see here I have less white balls than black balls. So automatically my probability that I probability of half of selecting white balls now seems a little bit far-fetched. But of course, even if there is less probability, I might still go a little bit farther and select the second bag. Here I have equal white and black balls. Or I might go towards this third bag and select a white ball from this. So I have an option of selecting a bag first and then select the ball. So this is a two-step process. So I should not directly calculate by looking at how many total balls do we have. So for this, what we'll do is we'll take two-step process. I'll say probability of selecting my first bag. The probability of selecting my first bag into, after selecting my first bag, what is the probability that I would select a white ball? So probability of selecting a white ball given that I have selected my first bag. So this becomes my conditional probability. Probability of selecting a white ball given I have already selected the first bag. Now, yahan par again, probability of selecting my second bag into probability that I will select a white ball given I have selected my second bag. And for the third one, same thing. In these three different ways, I can select a white ball from these three bags. So alternative, they are alternatives of each other. I'll just add them together. And this makes nothing but probability of selecting a white ball. I'll say W. Probability of selecting a white ball. Now this is nothing but our law of total probability. Now let's try and solve this and find out what would be the probability of selecting a white ball from these three bags. So here I have half into probability. Now if I have selected my first bag, probability of selecting a white ball, there are 10 white balls, 10 balls in this bag, out of which only 3 are white. So probability of selecting a white ball when I have already selected my first bag would be 3/10. And plus, again, I have selected my second bag. What is the probability that I'll select my white ball? So that is clearly 5/10 or 1/2. And here we'll have 7/10. We calculate this. I'll just say this is 3/2×10 plus 5/4×10 plus 7. So now I have probability of selecting a white ball is equals to 9/20. Beforehand we had probability half, now we have slightly less than half. Now 9/20, I can say it is basically half, right? So probability is nearly the same, just because there is slightly more complication. What do we have? We have more accurate probability. Now isme each of these 10 balls inside the bag, we are assuming are having equal probability of being selected. What if I said in each bag, I put the black balls first and then I put the white balls. So white balls are on the top of the black balls. So let's say probability of selecting those white balls will be a little bit different, a little bit more than probability of selecting those black balls. So automatically the probability of selecting a white ball will now change again. So we can, jitne zyada hum log complications add karte jayenge, utna zyada hamari probability aur accurate hoti jayegi. But that is the big trade-off. When I say probability of selecting a white ball is half, that does not inform me that whether the next time I will be selecting a white ball or a black ball. So this is what statistics is all about. This gives us an informed decision, but it cannot predict the future. But what does this tell us? This tells us ki if I select a ball n number of times, let's say 1,000 times, most likely half times I will get white balls and half times I will get black balls. Here I'm getting that the number of white balls will be slightly less than the black balls. Now, even if the probability was exactly half, I could still get, 505 black and 495 white, even when I had half, because this gives us a suggestion of what might happen, not prediction of what might happen. So probability is just a suggestion. It's just to make an informed decision. It will not give you an exact answer. दैट वॉज द रीजन जो हम लोगों ने स्टैटिस्टिक्स का स्टार्टिंग में डिस्कशन किया था कि स्टैटिस्टिक्स इज अ टूल नॉट एन एग्जैक्ट साइंस. ओके दैट इज व्हाई इट इज यूज्ड एज अ टूल नॉट एज एन एग्जैक्ट साइंस. वी कैन नॉट प्रिडिक्ट द फ्यूचर, वी कैन मेक एन इन्फॉर्म्ड डिसीजन. तो ये जो 9/20 है, अब उसके लिए क्या हो गया, नियरली सेम आंसर आया जो हमारा पहले हाफ था. एंड मोर और लेस मेरा आंसर जो फाइनली जो प्रिडिक्ट होने वाला है वो कोई बहुत ज्यादा डिफरेंट होने वाला नहीं है. सो इवन इफ आई से इट इज 9/20 और हाफ, द फाइनल मेरा जो डिसीजन होने वाला था दैट माइट नॉट चेंज. इट माइट, दिस विल स्टिल से मोर और लेस हाफ ऑफ द टाइम्स आई विल सी वाइट एंड हाफ ऑफ द टाइम्स आई विल सी ब्लैक. Here also, I was going to say half of the times I'll see white and half of the times I'll see black. So, ये ज़्यादा accurate करके फायदा क्या हुआ? Maybe अगर मैं ये probability bag one की probability और बढ़ा दूँ select करने, अगर मैं बोल दूँ probability of selecting the white first bag is 0.9, this bag is 0.05. This bag is 0.05. Then I will see a big change because ये first bag में ज़्यादा black balls हैं. So अब मैं उसको फटाक से कर लेता हूँ. So I'll have 0.9 into 0.3 plus 0.05 into 0.5. Now the probability is 33/100 or 0.33. Probability of selecting a white ball is 0.33. So sometimes this complication that we put in, that those balls were in bags, is makes a big difference. Sometimes it does not make a big difference. So it totally depends on complications काम का है या नहीं काम का है. In the previous sum, previous जो problem जो पहले मैंने लिखा था उसमें that complication may should be taken into consideration or not. I would have skipped taken that complication into consideration. But in the next sum, definitely I should take that complication into consideration. So as you can see that if in the first one if I take half or 9/20, my final informed decision was more or less the same. So I should or I might skip the complication. In the second one, I should take the complication. So इस तरीके से हम लोगों को informed decision लेना पड़ता है कि हम लोगों ने complications लेने चाहिए या नहीं चाहिए. Because finally, does that make a big difference or not? जितने ज़्यादा complications हम लोग डालते जाएंगे, उतना ज़्यादा calculation difficult होता जाएगा, and उतना ज़्यादा time लगेगा हमको वो informed decision लेने. Now let's assume that we were doing something on stock market. Stock market में कितने जल्दी वो values change होती. So if I need to predict a value कि मैंने उसमें invest करना चाहिए या नहीं invest करना चाहिए, उसके लिए I need to make very quick decisions. And if I take too much time in calculating, then that might cost me money. So that time I'll have to make an informed decision कि मैंने उसमें complications ज़्यादा लेने चाहिए या simplification लेके accuracy कम लेनी चाहिए. So we have to keep an balance between accuracy and complications. So that is what statistics is all about. You have to decide whether to take more complications or whether to accept less accuracy. Okay, it's totally up to the person who is taking that into account. And how would you make that decision? By making a decision of how much important that accuracy is for you. जैसे अगर मैं बोलता हूँ कि मेरा जो stock market की value है, I am getting 10% accuracy, or let's say 10% inaccuracy, 10% की range मिल रही है मुझे. 10% ऊपर हो सकता है, 10% नीचे हो सकता है, plus minus 10% for let's say 5% complication. Versus I am getting, let's say, range of plus minus 7% for 95% complication, or I'll just say 90% complication. So ab yahan par kya ho gaya ki I have complicated my process so much more for a very small accuracy, only 3% ki accuracy zyada badi hai, ya bol sakte ho 3% se kam hua hai hamara range. Okay, so I might not go for this particular change. I would say ki kam complication lekar thoda sa zyada agar meko range milta hai to chal jayega, but this will make my calculations easier. Okay, anyways, ye decisions tumko baad mein lene padenge, not in CS1, but we will understand how statistics work in CS1, and that will help you understand how to make these kind of decisions. So again, back, agar question aata hai ki the balls are in 3 bags, you cannot directly say the probability would be half, kyunki answer nearly half aaya. This is not going to be your answer. Your answer is going to be 9/20. Okay, jaisa question diya hua hai uske hisab se we have to solve it. So this becomes our law of total probability. If we have more complications, we can use that complication number of steps to find our total probability. So uske liye formula hai. यहाँ पे मतलब क्या हो गया, वी आर फर्स्ट सिलेक्टिंग अ बैग एंड देन सिलेक्टिंग अ बॉल. दिस इज टू स्टेप प्रोसेस. अभी नेक्स्ट टॉपिक विल हैव बेस थ्योरम. दिस इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक, क्योंकि ये आगे जाके भी काम आएगा. वी हैव अ फुल चैप्टर कॉल्ड बेजियन स्टैटिस्टिक्स लेटर ऑन, एंड दैट यूजेस द सेम बेस थ्योरम. ओके, so Bayes theorem says probability of E2 given A must be equal to probability of E2 into probability A given E2 upon summation probability EI into probability A given EI. तो यहाँ पर क्या हो रहा है, यहाँ पर अगेन जो हमारे जो पहले वाले अजम्पशंस है वो सारे के सारे हमने अजम्पशंस ले लिए. जो लॉ ऑफ टोटल प्रोबेबिलिटी है, जो हमारे ये दोनों अजम्पशंस थे, वी हैव टेकन द बोथ अजम्पशंस, वी हैव द सेम डायग्राम, वी हैव द सेम कॉम्प्लिकेशंस. तो यहाँ पर वी आर सेइंग प्रोबेबिलिटी दैट ए इज गिवन, दैट मीन्स वाइट बॉल निकल चुका है. आई नीड टू फिगर आउट वॉट इज द प्रोबेबिलिटी दैट इट came from a particular bag. It came from our second bag. Now इसका क्या use हो सकता है ये बाद में बताऊंगा, पहले mathematics देख लेते हैं. So just using our conditional probability, we know this is A intersection E2 upon probability of. So this is what we have. Now, because of law of total probability, we know probability of A is nothing but our summation I going from 1 to n probability of EI into probability of A given EI. ये भी हम लोगों ने लिखा था. And probability A intersection E2, if I say probability A given E2 is equals to probability of A intersection E2 upon probability of E2. So again, A intersection E2 can be written as probability of E2, probability of A given E2. So this is how we get our Bayes theorem ka formula. It comes from simple our conditional probability and law of total probability. Now we can use this formula directly. Now we'll use the same concept. Ye jo bag wala jo question tha, rather than ye 0.9, 0.05, ye wala jo complication tha, I'll not use that. I'll use 0. This was half. Okay, this half 1/4. This is what complication we are going to use. Just a minute, huh? So yahi pe, and we'll try to figure out what is the probability that the ball came from the second bag given it was a white ball. Ye hum log find karne ki koshish kar rahe. According to Bayes theorem, this is going to be probability E2 into probability A W given E2, probability and summation. Actually probability of A likh deta hu ya probability of W likh deta hu, because you have already calculated that. Okay, so that is why I'll directly write this. Otherwise we'll have to do our summation here in the denominator. So iske hisab se I will have this 1/4 into 5/10. So that is 5/10 upon 9/20. So we are getting 5/8. 5/18. That is our answer. 5/18. Now what does this mean? This means that there is 5/18 chances, or whatever decimal mein agar kar le to 0.27778. Okay. So there is 27.78% chances that the ball, the white ball that we have selected, came from the second bag. Okay. So we know that white ball aa gaya hai. Now we are trying to figure out what are the chances that it came from a particular bag. Now ye kahan par kaam aata hai? Now this is very useful in something like, let's say you are manufacturing a mobile phone and you have two different factories. So factory one is a factory jahan pe, let's say 10,000 mobiles are made. Okay. And usme se 10,000 mobiles mein se let's say 0.05, or I'll just say 5% mobiles are defective, and your factory 2 makes, let's say 5,000 mobiles, and out of those 5,000 mobiles, let's say 15% are defective. Or I'll just take, let's say 9% are defective. We'll not take such a big difference. Okay, 9% are defective, and yahan par 5% are defective. So now, if you are, let's say, you know, renewing a factory such that ki tumhara jo ye परसेंटेज जो डिफेक्टिव है वो कम हो जाएगा. सो उसके लिए विच वन शुड यू रिन्यू फर्स्ट? Now, just by looking at these factories, we might say that this is 9% defective. So definitely we should change this factory, because more defective product will become less. So we can reduce the number of defective products here more. But this does not tell us the whole picture, because if you just calculate how many defective are here, so 10,000 ka 5% is going to be 500 defective products, and 5,000 ka 9%, I'll just calculate that, 5,000 ka 9%, 0.09, is going to be 450. So even if out of these 5,000 more products are defective, this becomes the 9% of 5,000, but you can clearly see overall this factory is giving you more defective products. So if you better your factory one, it would be much much more cost effective, or you can say much more profitable for you, because it will reduce the number of defectives that are contributing to more defective products overall. So iske liye agar tumhe find karna hota, this is just factory one, factory two, sirf do hi factory liya hua hai, where I have taken these numbers so that I could explain you this very easily. But assume that you have 10 different factories. Ab uske liye tum aise har ek ke liye calculate karte rahoge and then compare karte rahoge. Usse better kya hoga? You will calculate this base theorem. So you'll say, what is the probability that let's say factory 2, a defective product comes from factory 2, given that it is defective. So iske liye hum log same ye example leke calculate karne ki koshish karte hain. So probability that F1 kya hai? Total 15,000 products hai. 15,000 mein se 10,000 come from F1. So I can say 2/3, and probability of F2 is equals to 1/3. Okay. That's pretty simple. 10,000 by 15,000 and 5,000 by 15,000. So a product coming from factory 1 is 2/3. A product coming from factory 2 is 1/3. Probability that a product is defective given it came from factory 1. So 5% of all factory 1 products are defective. So I'll say that is 0.05. And probability that a product is defective given it came from factory 2, 9% of all factory 2 products are defective. So that gives me 0.09. So this is our given information. If I need to find out probability that a product came from factory 2 given it was already defective. So I have selected a product and I am getting that it is a defective product. What is the probability that it came from factory 2? So uske liye we'll say product probability factory 2 into probability defective given factory 2 upon probability factory 1 to probability defective given factory 1 plus probability factory 2. Probability defective given factory 2. This becomes our base theorem. Just by using one single theorem, we can easily find this probability, and it will be 1/3 into 0.09 by 2/3 into 0.05 plus 1. So finally, getting 0.09 by 2 into So we got 9 by 19. Okay. So clearly, factory 2 is producing less defective products than factory 1. So factory 1, clearly, because there were only two factories, I can say probability F1 given D must be 10 by 19. Because 9 by 19 were from factory 2 to 10 by 19 comes from factory 1. So this way we can make an informed decision. So similarly, if I have 20 different factories, or even if I have only 5 different factories, I calculate this way. This becomes so much easier for us to calculate. And say I don't need to actually have the numbers of how many defective products I had, how many total products I am producing. Yeah, even if that number is really large, I don't need to use that directly. I can use the probabilities that I have to calculate these particular figures. So this becomes our Bayes' theorem. So this is the last topic of our chapter, probability. We'll talk about chapter 1 and chapter 3 a little bit, but mostly we'll be doing that in the next class. Okay. Iske mein thode se sums pehle de deta hun. So let's do one particular sum at least from Bayes' theorem. Just a Now do this sum. In a certain constituency, 30% of the voters are blue collar workers, of whom 46% voted conservatively at the last United Kingdom election. Of the remaining voters, 36% voted conservatively. Consider a voter selected at random from those who voted conservatively in this constituency. What is the probability that this vote is a blue collar worker? Hello, question. I'll be back in 1 minute. चलो ये सो यहाँ पे क्या बोला हुआ है, दे आर सेइंग इन अ सर्टेन कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी 30% आर ब्लू कॉलर वोटर्स. सो प्रोबेबिलिटी ब्लू कॉलर बी इज इक्वल्स टू 30% और इट्स 0.3. सो फॉर नॉट ब्लू कॉलर आई विल जस्ट राइट एन बी, प्रोबेबिलिटी एन बी देन मस्ट बी 0.7. They are saying of whom 46% voted conservatively. So out of these blue collar voters, 46% voted conservatively. So we'll say probability that conservative C given blue collar voter is going to be 0.46. And bola hua of the remaining voters, 36 voted conservatively. So probability that voted conservatively given the person is not a blue collar voter is 0.36. We need to find, consider a voter selected randomly from those who voted conservatively. So we know that the voter has voted conservatively. What is the probability that this voter is a blue collar voter? So probability that blue collar voter given voted conservatively, that would be. Now isko kabhi bhi likhte waqt you will realize ki base theorem wale question mein the probability jo banne wali hai given and whatever is exactly opposite of whatever is given to us. You can see one of these two may say opposite wali aane wali. So B given C. So how do we remember to write the formula of it? So remember, we'll have to change this into C given B. So we'll have probability C given B. Then jo given part hai, uski probability se multiply karte hai. So into probability of B. And then upon, we want to write this again, probability of B into probability of C given B and the other ones. So plus we'll have probability of NB into probability of C given NB. ऐसे चार भी रहेंगे तो चारों के चारों नीचे लिखने पड़ेंगे. So this is how we actually make these formulas of or remember how to write these formulas. So उसके हिसाब से इतना हो गया. So we are getting 23 by 65 or 0.3538. So ye kya hamara answer. So this is how we will use our base theorem. So what does this say? That if we know a person has voted conservatively, probability that the person is a blue collar voter is going to be 35%. So even though you can see here ki non blue collar voters voting conservatively are less than blue. Kal ke jaise aaj bhi I will send the questions to solve as a PDF. Okay, so वैसे ही भेज दूंगा. Other than that, now I'll give you a brief idea about other chapters. And ये chapter तो हमारा हो गया है. Probability खत्म हो गया है. We'll do basic chapter 1, that would be summary of data. Okay, so we'll be doing summary of data, basic chapter one. Okay. So first of all, most of us, अगर थोड़ा बहुत statistics पढ़ा होगा तो उसमें जो mean, median, mode and everything पढ़ा होगा, that comes into the summary of data. That is again our basic chapter. That उसके direct questions नहीं आएंगे, but obviously whatever we are going to study here will be used in our actual course. Okay, so don't take कि ये आने नहीं वाला है तो we should skip it or something like that. These are all important chapters as well. Okay, so first of all, when we talk about data, so data is of two types. So we say we have numerical data and we have categorical data. जब न्यूमेरिकल डेटा बोलते हैं तो एनीथिंग दैट हैज नंबर्स इन इट, जस्ट दैट कैन बी रिप्रेजेंटेड एज नंबर्स, दैट वील कॉल इट एज न्यूमेरिकल डेटा. कैटेगरिकल डेटा, एनीथिंग दैट वी कैन नॉट रिप्रेजेंटेड एज अ नंबर, वील राइट इट एज कैटेगरिकल डेटा. उसमें सिंपल से एग्जाम्पल अगर मैं लू कैटेगरिकल डेटा का, तो आई विल से यस और नो, और लेट्स से जेंडर, और कलर, सो दीज आर कैटेगरिकल डेटा. आई कैन नॉट से दैट ब्लू इज वन, रेड इज टू एंड ग्रीन इज थ्री एवरी सिंगल टाइम. दैट इज नॉट हाउ इट इज गोइंग टू वर्क. आई कैन नॉट रिप्रेजेंट देम एज नंबर्स एंड एक्चुअली डू एनी काइंड ऑफ एनालिसिस ऑन. सो कैटेगरिकल डेटा में अलग टाइप के एनालिसिस होते हैं एंड न्यूमेरिकल डेटा में अलग टाइप के एनालिसिस. So we are going to see analysis only on numerical data in our whole course, so you don't have to worry about categorical data. Now numerical data, we have two types of numerical data. We have discrete and we have continuous. Now discrete, we always say number of something is discrete. So I'll say example mein number of students, anything, number of policies, number of claims, number of pencils, number of days in a week, these are all discrete values. So discrete value mein kya hota hai, simply we start from a particular value and there is always a difference of some particular values, then we call it as a discrete. Same difference rehta 0 1 2 3 4 5 6, there is a difference of 1, unke beech mein koi value ko hum consider nahi karte, that is discrete. Continuous, when each value is considered between any two values, then we say it is continuous. Now continuous ka example, if I say height, height of a student. So height, even though we measure it as a discrete value, it will be continuous. Now in actuality, height ke saath saath hum time bol sakte hain. Time is also a continuous value. One of the things we measure in time is going to be age. But even if age is a continuous continuous data, we actually treat age as a discrete data. मैं अगर तुमको पूछूंगा what is your age, you are not going to say कि 22 years, 5 months, 3 days and 2 hours. ऐसे तो बोलने वाले हो नहीं. You are going to say either 22 years or you will say 22 and half, या फिर you will say almost 23. इस तरीके से बात करेंगे हम लोग. So very rarely you will find that age is represented as a continuous data. We always use use age as a discrete data. So bhale age is continuous, it is an example of discrete. So height ke liye, if I say height of a building is definitely continuous, but if I say number of floors, that would be a discrete data. So if I represent height in terms of number of floors, we do that a lot because usually we assume that a floor is of same height for every every building. So we say the building is 10 floors or the building is 8 floors. So you can obviously measure the height and compare them, and you'll say 10 floor building is taller than 8 floor building. So in that manner, we sometimes also convert continuous data into discrete data just because it is easier for us to represent it and compare, rather than saying the height of that building was these many feet or these many meters. It would be easier for us to represent height of a building in terms of floors. So clearly, if I say 50 floor building and I have a 70 floor building, so clearly 70 floor building will be taller than 50 floor building. Even though the floor height of 70 floor building might be a little bit less than 50 floor building, but clearly we know it will be taller. So is tarike se kya hota hai? We represent few things as discrete, even if it is a continuous data. Even if I ask you your height, you will tell me something like 175 centimeters, or you will tell me in inches. So ye kya ho gaya, 175 ya 176 bologe, ya zyada se zyada 175.5 centimeters. So again, kya ho jata hai, we are representing it in discrete, not in continuous. In actuality, your height might be 175.47936 centimeters, but you are representing it as a discrete value. So we prefer to write continuous value or represent continuous value in terms of discrete. And sometimes we actually prefer to represent discrete value in continuous forms as well. ये सब चीजें हम लोग बाद में देखेंगे, कैसे हम लोग एक चीज को दूसरे में represent करेंगे, तो फिर उसमें data analysis हम लोग कैसे करेंगे. This becomes data. Now in actuality, statistics does not just depend on analyzing a data, but it starts from collecting a data. Now obviously that is not part of our course. How do we collect, how do we sort, how do we tabulate or anything, ye sab cheeze nahi hai hamare course. Hamara jo course hai, that is totally dependent on analysis of data. So we'll go for analysis. So now we have two types of data, discrete and continuous. Dono ka hum log analysis dekhenge. In this chapter we'll only see discrete data. Thoda bahut continuous ke bare mein baat karenge, but mostly we'll be seeing discrete data only. So iske upar analysis ke thoda sa baat karta hu main, and then we'll end our class today and we'll do later on. Na kya hota hai, jaise abhi hum log comparison ki baat kar rahe the, comparison mein when I talked about height of two building, now because their number of the assumption that the height of a floor would be almost same, that is why we could compare two building by just the number of floors, but that may not be always the same. So that is why we need some kind of analysis tools to compare. You say first tool is average. So any analysis may, first tool is average, that we also call it as central tendencies. We'll talk about central tendencies tomorrow in detail. We'll just say what they are. So we have three averages. We have mean, we have median, and we have mode. We have three averages. Okay. Again, ye sab detail mein hum log baad mein baat karenge. Okay. First of all, वी आर मोस्टली टॉकिंग अबाउट डिस्क्रीट डेटा. डिस्क्रीट के हिसाब से वी हैव मीन का फॉर्मूला. नाउ देर आर टू डिफरेंट वेज वी कैन रिप्रेजेंट आर मीन. द फर्स्ट वन वुड बी वी से x बार लिखते हैं हम लोग. x बार इज नथिंग बट आर सैंपल मीन एंड वी हैव म्यू. म्यू वी कॉल इट एज पॉपुलेशन मीन. Again, the difference between sample and population, as we go on, you will understand it very much. Ki why we have sample and population two different things. Right now, we are not going too much into it. The formula for that is same. We say summation x, we add up all values divided by n. Or we write it as summation fx by summation f whenever we have frequencies. I'll always write summation f as n only. Okay, it's just easier for us to do. And for population mean, we have the same formula. There's no difference between the formulas. That becomes our mean. So right now, we'll end the class here. Okay. And we'll do the आगे का part later on. ठीक है, इतना I hope लिख लिया होगा. ठीक है, we'll continue from here. We'll talk about mean, we'll talk about median and mode, and we'll go further different types of analysis. चलो, any doubts, especially in Bayes theorem and this analysis? I don't think इसमें कोई problem होगी. Bayes theorem में अगर कुछ problem रही, I will give you more sums to solve and then we'll discuss them tomorrow. Okay, we'll end the class here. Or kuch problem rahe to definitely you can ask me on WhatsApp as well.